This is Eric K. Thomas with the Corner Center Gentlemen, QGTV, and we're here at the 22nd Annual American Black Film Festival here in Miami. And we're sitting here with Tristan Mack and Miss Chaley Rose. How you guys doing? You all right?
Good. Yeah.
Amazing.
Good. Yeah.
Awesome. So right now we here because you guys have dinner for two.
Yes.
What's going on with that? I know TV won, but let's talk about it.
Dinner for Two is a movie that, of course, me and Chaley are starring in. And it's an amazing movie about this man named Chris who is going through a very, very rough patch in his life with the loss of his mother and a bunch of other things that kind of led him down a very depressive state. And he decides to go home and cook himself one last meal before he ends it all. And as he begins to start cooking, she shows up at the door.
Okay.
And his estranged wife.
Wow. Okay. So, and it's Angela, right?
Yes.
I'm like Angela. So, kind of, what's your role in this?
I am the protector.
Okay. The voice of reason.
The voice of reason. We meet in college and we fall in love and we have our trials and we break up and we get back together. But no matter what, we have each other's backs. So I come that day and he's making his last dinner and as time goes by, I can see that he's not in a good place, and I'm just kind of fighting with him and urging him to seek help and to live his life.
It sounds a lot like I don't know, mental health, maybe like a little depression things in
definitely
there.
Kind depression, of that. Alcoholism.
Right. How was it in, why was it important to be a part of this particular project to talk on those particular aspects that kind of playing everyday kind of world that we live in right now?
I think it's just what you said. It's something that happens all the time. And I think as of late we've been getting a lot more notoriety, but I think mental health is a very serious issue that a lot of people don't take into account how healthy someone's mind is, especially when they go through the different trials and tribulations that life hands you. So I think this is a movie that kind of it kind of stresses the issue of just understanding where you are and kind of having a great support system.
Yeah, and seeing that there is a way out, but it's probably in his situation, it was up to him to fight.
So we're here at the American Black Film Festival. Why is it so important for these type of films to kind of come through these festival kind of circuits? Why do you think so?
I think it's great to have a festival where people come and support black film and television. It is. It's also nice to be able to go to a festival and see yourself represented repeatedly. Whereas for certain festivals, you might go and be like, these are some good movies that I don't relate to. It's necessary, and I think it's an opportunity to give a lot more black filmmakers a platform. We can have nice things too.
Absolutely, it's a stage. It's an open opportunity for our voices to be heard, for our stories to be told, and for people to know that we're not one-sided, that there's many facets to who we are, our culture, and the experience of being African-American or minority, period.
And my last question for you is, what do you want people to take after they see Dinner for Two?
I was relieved when a few people said they cried. I was so happy to hear that.
That's what you want. You want to make people cry. Okay, got it.
Cry at the end, but I just, it's the story, I think, in the end is that, there is a light at the end of the tunnel, and I hope people walk away feeling moved, like they went for a ride, and feel uplifted.
I want people to understand the message behind the story, which is like you know, help, the self-help starts with self.
Right.
You know, I want people to have a good time. I want people to be there to laugh when we laugh, to cry when we cry, to actually enjoy, because it's a roller coaster ride. Like, there's amazing, funny moments, and there's very, very sad moments. So it's like you're going through the whole ride with us, and I just want everybody who watches at home to strap in and take that ride with us.
Awesome. So you guys here, Dinner for Two, TV One, look out for it. Thank you.